money to satisfy his appetite, and now he's going to make everybody pay for his poor leadership.
State budget battle. Harsh words tonight for Governor Chet Culver from the people who want his job. Good evening, and thanks for staying up late with us.
This week, we're expecting to hear the bad news from the State Department directors on how they'll implement a 10% budget cut.
On Thursday, Governor Culver issued the executive order to cut $600 million in spending. That puts jobs, services, and support for Iowans at risk.
Of course, the reason state tax collections are falling short of projections by $415 million, and things don't look any better anytime soon. But tonight, some Republicans say it's partly the governor's fault that we're even in this situation.
News Channel 8's Gary Gavin has more.
Well, tonight, the Polk County Republicans held their kickoff rally for the 2010 campaign. The five Republicans who have announced they'll be running for governor were all there tonight, and they all think this big budget mess might help them beat Culver in the election.
For these Republican leaders, the next governor election can't come soon enough. Although the 2010 campaign season is just beginning, this announcement from Governor Culver on Thursday is certainly on their minds.
I arrived at this decision after a lot of thought and deliberation. So this afternoon, I will be signing Executive Order Number 19 to implement an across-the-board cut of 10%, which becomes effective today.
I think that was unfortunate because we didn't wake up Wednesday morning realizing there was a significant problem with the state's finances. This thing has been unfolding for a matter of months.
He's been spending the taxpayers' money, and he's been spending it so fast that now he's having to backtrack. So the very idea that you're just not paying enough in taxes is not right. We've had close to record revenue, but we spent at a record pace.
Governor Culver and the unions have kept raising wages and raising benefits to the point that it can't be supported anymore. And I think you're looking at hundreds of layoffs.
What troubles me the most is when asked, would you do anything differently? The governor said no. And I think Iowa needs somebody that learns from their mistakes. And it was a mistake to grow government that fast. It's clear now.
There's been poor preparation on the governor and his administration's part that's going to constitute an emergency on everybody's part in the state of Iowa. So he's going to throw everybody under the 10% cut bus equally.
Tonight, Governor Culver's campaign manager responded to the Republican comments. This is what he had to say.
All the governors in the country are dealing with this. Every state is. So it's not news that they said they knew it was coming. Everyone knew the numbers would be bad. The reason he didn't go to special session is that he wanted to not push the burden off on other people. He wanted to take a bold, decisive step himself to make sure this got done.
Now, Andrew also said the governor wants these cuts done as soon as possible, so it's likely this week we'll be hearing what exactly is going to be cut, and it doesn't look like it's going to be good news.
Perhaps some very big decisions made this weekend.
Absolutely.
Thanks, Carrie.